IT Talent College presents Maarten Louwman, co-founder of the Key Foundation on privacy. Hi.
All right, digital self-determination. What does it mean if you have a trias politica model for the governments, if you have a new layer and infrastructure on the internet? What can it do? What does it mean today? Well, I've presented some examples for you. And in fact, what I would like to do is to invite you to start using the Key Trust Framework and to activate your own node. And what I would like to invite you is to install a small app on your phone. And we know you can trust them, but if you don't fill in too much data, it's not worse than it was. So, well, let's do it. Please, use your phone and and install this. Well, it's a bit difficult to read, but it says Dapper, D-A-P-P-R-E. And what it does, I will tell you, because you're all reluctant to install, of course, what it does is that it makes it possible for you to connect to your neighbor and to subscribe to the data your neighbor is willing to share with you. So in fact, this is an automated address book for a start. So if you go for people with a Windows phone, I have to disappoint them, it's not ready yet, but for Android people, sorry. For Android people and iPhone people, please install. All right. For the people who installed it, if you fill in under my card, if you fill in your first name and your last name, that will do for a starter. And if you have it, then it says there's this small button, share. And what share does is that it creates a QR code, which will last for about half an hour, three quarters of an hour. And as you know each other or you see each other, you decide whether you trust your neighbor or not. And if you trust this person, you might as well connect because you all share one thing here, and that's your interest in privacy matters. So you have all, you have something in common. So if that's so, why not start a group and connect? And the interesting thing is, because this is only the step up, it's very small. It's from a person to a person, and if you trust someone, you might as well connect to him. And the fun thing is, of course, that if you have this, you don't have to worry about whether these contact details are valid or not, because this other person will hold them for you, and you are subscribed to the data this other person is willing to share with you. And that's the whole idea, because you are in control of your data. And if you have a connection with someone and you don't like him or her anymore, you just break the connection and the data will be gone. You are in control of your data. And with the same system, if you go to a web shop, this is a worked example we have been working on last year together with a couple of banks and Equens and a ministry and Social Insurance Bank of the Netherlands joint. And what came out was that today your digital experience is always very lousy if you go web shopping, because you always have to start this account. Otherwise, you cannot buy anything. And that's very strange, because in the real world, you could go to a bookshop and they wouldn't ask you when you entered the shop, can I have your email address and please tell me where you live? And oh, by the way, are you over 18? You just enter a shop and you buy a book. And if you pay cash, like Richard would do, then they wouldn't know anything about you. Here, when we're going online, you cannot buy anything usually at the bol.coms and the Amazons. You always need to open up an account. what we are trying to achieve is that your experience in the digital world is equivalent, is similar to the one you have online, in the real world. What we have here is some a web shop with idiot prices and idiot stuff, but it doesn't matter, it's an example. It's a working example. And what I could do here is open up another account, and another app, and this app is connected to the same node as this Dapper application. And I have it here. Please show, have a look. Well, it's me, yes. My picture, but the thing is they don't need to know. What I can do is, by way of a pseudo ID, connect to this web shop, buying something there without an account, and as this note of me is connected to my bank as well, and possibly even to the Dutch Post. And if Dutch Post has my address, and I would buy something here, I wouldn't have to tell them the address where I want it delivered. Because if PostNL knows where all my groceries and all the stuff should be delivered, then I only have to give PostNL the code of this webshop company, and PostNL will collect it for me, and not only at the webshop, but also at Amazon Distribution Center, and probably at Wakamp and the supermarket as well. And they, PostNL, will grab it for me, and they will bring it on my address where I want it delivered on a specific time when I'm home or at this specific place. Okay. What happens here is that if I use this app, and the same thing happens, I'm connecting. What happens there is that you see your key connected. It's a bit difficult to see, but here on my phone, you can see there's this technical message. Yep, a technical message. Well, not that interesting, but they don't need to know. There's someone which is connected to this infrastructure. If I start buying ridiculous things like this Pelican and this Eames chair, and maybe this boombox, and I go to the checkout, well, I even bought two chairs, I see. There's this €1,494. Well, okay, I want it to have. Okay, so this is it. I didn't enter anything, but what I see here is they, as I push the button buy, they send out a question in my network. Is there an address we can deliver? And what you see here in the app, can you read it loud?
Yeah, may we use this validated address in on your address?
Yep. May we use this validated address in Boxtel? And it says yes or no. This is just a simple message system. I say yes. And the next thing that happens is that they are going to ask a question in my network using nodes. Is there an organization that can guarantee the payment of this amount? What happens then is that if they found a bank that guarantees my payment, then they receive the guarantee of the bank. They still don't know who I am, but it's enough for them. It's a SEPA transfer credit. I receive the message that it's okay, and I'm done. And next time I come here, I could be completely blank again and start all over. Or you can imagine that as I have specific measurements, maybe I want to buy shoes. You can imagine that there's this anonymous attribute, the size of my shoes, which I'm always giving to this web shop. So next time I might use the same pseudo ID and they might have my measurements. Or if I don't want to, they don't. I'm in control. So this is what's happening right now here in the Netherlands and in Belgium. And we have only taken the first step to make this all happen, and we all need your support. So if you like this idea, please let me know. We're hiring, and we're looking for organizations that really would like to have this going. By the way, in this today, tonight, there are several organizations that already support this. Thank you.